Welcome back to Twinkle Tunes and Lighting. Today we're talking about cables, connectors, and safety. This is going to be a big one. Another big decisions are going to have to happen in your guys' show. Stick around, I'll help you make it. Let's go. Let's start with cables. For LED setups, you'll be using stranded wire. Don't go with the hard copper wire. Don't go with the solid core copper wire. Some people do it. I'm not telling you not to. Stick with the stranded stuff. It's simple, it's easy to work with. Stranded wire, 18 gauge to 14 gauge, that's what we're working with. That's what all the cable standards come in, okay? 18 gauge to 14 gauge. The lower the gauge, the lower the number, the thicker the copper and the thicker the wire is gonna be. So a 14 gauge is a little bit thicker than an 18 gauge. 12 gauge is obviously a lot thicker than an 18 gauge or a 20 gauge. And as you go on the opposite ends, they get bigger and they get smaller, okay? We wanna stick between 14 and 18 gauge. Stick in that area, it's nice and safe. You're gonna wanna use 18 gauge for shorter runs. If you're running just a few feet or a couple meters, you wanna use 18 gauge, that's fine. If you're going anything further than that, you wanna have a little bit bigger of a wire. Let's jump over to 14 gauge so we get those little bit longer distances. The reason in that DC current that we talked about in our early videos, that cable has resistance in it. By the time you run your power down that cable and that data, it takes energy to try to get it to that first light and the first prop. And before it gets there, that is what you want, that thicker cable so it can travel down there. The thinner cable has more resistance and it's gonna have a harder time getting down those distances. I always say choose stranded over solid core. I don't have any solid core. Some people build their control boxes with solid core. I don't, okay? Use stranded, all stranded. Here is the big controversy of what type of connector am I gonna use on my cables. In my mind, there's three standard connectors, or probably more. For other people out there are like, oh, there's more than three because I got the other one. That's all right. This is what I'm saying. This is how I look at it. There's three standard connectors. Number one, you got a JST connector. Number two, you got a X connect. And number three, you have a Reiwu connector. Those are the top three. Those are top three connectors that you're gonna find standard on all your pixels. Each one has its pros and its cons. Once again, the main thing you wanna do is be consistent in your connectors. If you're gonna be an X Connect house, everything is gonna be X Connect. Don't sit there and swap and go back and forth. If you're a Reiwu house, be a Reiwu house. If you're gonna be a JST connector, be a JST. Everything I run is all Reiwu, all of it. All of it's Reiwu. I don't have adapters that goes from Reiwu to X Connect. I don't do any of that stuff. It's all Reiwu. If I buy a light and it's got a different connector on it, I chop the connector off and I put a Reiwu on there. Everything is Reiwu. You don't want to dork around and have adapters to adapt the adapter to make the adapter work. I wouldn't do that. They sell them. I wouldn't do that. All right, we're gonna look at a 5-volt versus 12-volt setup. We're gonna be looking at the fuses, we're gonna be looking at the tails. Okay, so there's a lot that's gonna be going on in this next section here. Power wiring is more than just plugging things in. It's about safe, stable power delivery, okay? We wanna be safe, we wanna be stable, we wanna make sure we're delivering our power correctly. If you are running power and there's not a fuse somewhere in line, don't do it. Put a fuse in there. When you get these smart controllers, 99% of all of them already have fuses in line. So if you're connecting that, going fused and fused out, you're gonna be golden. I would purchase in your arsenal of tools and things like that, I would purchase a voltmeter. Get yourself a voltage meter so you always know what power power is coming out, what power is going in, so that you can see and make sure that your lights are getting the correct voltage, if they're getting 5 or they're getting 12. Don't just trust when you open up the box and it says 12 volts on there and you go, he seems like a nice guy. And you take it out and you connect it all together and guess what? It's popping out 5 volts or it's popping out 24 volts, okay? They're making thousands of these boxes every day. Something's gonna get mislabeled, okay? So make sure you're checking your voltage. Make sure everything is labeled. Label your stuff. You're gonna make hundreds of connections. You're not gonna remember them all, okay? You're gonna have different colored wires. Sometimes people use red, black, and white. Sometimes people use the orange and yellow and green, and there's all kinds of different. Label your wires. If you're going to a positive and negative, it doesn't matter what color it is. If it's labeled positive, it's a positive wire. If it's negative, it's a negative wire. It's a data wire. So make sure everything is labeled, over-label. You cannot label enough. If you open your box and it's all labeled and you go, oh, that's exactly what it looks like, that's a great thing. If you open your box and it's a mess, and now you're sitting there trying to figure out, oh wait, was that cable that I purchased earlier that didn't work? That I don't know what to do, no, fire. Okay, we don't want that. Okay, pop fuses, we don't want that. Label stuff. And this should be in everybody's house and in everybody's outside in their props. Go get a fire extinguisher. They're like 20 bucks. Go get one. It's gonna save your house, probably save your life, okay? So have it, stick it by your shop, stick it by outside. Okay, that way if you have any accidents, go get a fire extinguisher. That's the only thing I'd say, that's a must. Go get a fire extinguisher. That's your crash course into cables, connectors, and safety. In our next video, now that we've got our power supply, we've got our lights, we've got our controller, we've got our connectors and our wire, what are we ready for now? We're ready for some software. Let's start making everything talk. Stick around, the next video is gonna talk all about the software to make this cool stuff happen. Thanks so much for watching. Make sure you like and subscribe. Hit that bell icon. Lots more cool videos coming up. And thanks again.